This is Tricks of the 3D Game Programming Gurus by Andre Lamothe. If I remember correctly, this is the first book on 3D graphics that I ever bought. It came out in 2003 and I think I bought it in 2007 when I started working on DirectX drivers at Intel. This book is massive! No less than 1,759 pages and weighs almost 2.6 kilograms. A real monster. This book will teach you everything you need to know about how to develop a complete software rasterizer from scratch. Now, I know what you're thinking. What's the point in writing a software rasterizer? Not just today, even in 2003 when hardware acceleration using DX9 was already available. The main reason, I guess, is that if you really want to understand how the entire 3D pipeline works, you need to develop a software rasterizer yourself, at least once, you know. Andre himself says that real programmers need to be able to write a full 3D engine from scratch, including the rasterizer. I guess he was under the impression of John Carmack and the Doom and Quake engines. I'm not sure he would say the same thing today. Anyway, the book begins by explaining how a game works, you know, the render loop and all that crap. Then it teaches you how to create a window in Windows and get direct access to the frame buffer. Then it explains everything about 3D math, vectors, matrices, quaternions, and transformations. The next step is to write the entire math library yourself. That's right, no GLM. There are no shortcuts. You need to get it working yourself. Then the real fun starts when you begin the development of the rasterizer. First wireframe, then full triangles. From there, we get to clipping and then the depth buffer. I think that this is the point where I left the book for some reason that I can't even remember and moved on to other projects. But if you hang in there, you've got advanced texturing, including bilinear filtering and meat mapping, and also important topics such as binary space partitioning, which were very popular back then. The book ends with a couple of chapters that discuss shadows, lighting, and various techniques that were used at id Software. Again, John Carmack. And we've also got a chapter on skeletal animation, where we learn how to load the MD2 model files from Quake and how to do collision detection. The final chapter is about CPU optimizations. So, would I recommend getting this book today? It depends on how much you want to go deeper into 3D graphics and how much time you're willing to spend on such a project. I think that from an educational standpoint, this book has a lot to offer, and young programmers would find it especially challenging because you really need to debug stuff down at the pixel level. It's up to you. The book is still available on eBay and even on Amazon if you have the money for it. Personally, I would love to get back to this book at some point and do it all over again. I really like Andre's style and working through the book was a lot of fun. So that was One Day, One Book. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.